In this lecture, we will discuss about prototype design pattern. Prototype design pattern is used to create an object by cloning a prototype. Okay, let's see the intent of prototype pattern. Specify the kinds of objects to create using a prototypical instance and create new objects by copying this prototype. So we have two things. Specify the kinds of objects to create using a prototypical instance and create new objects by copying this prototype. Okay, let's have a thought process for a problem and how we will come up with the solution. We have an application that requires to create objects of Linux, Windows, and MongoDB. It is simple. We can have System Creator which will create these objects. Okay. Let's stick to Linux and MongoDB only. Suppose it's a framework, then how it will know about Linux and MongoDB as it is specific to application and System Creator belongs to framework. Okay, we can have System Creator and application system in framework. Linux Creator and MongoDB Creator will be provided by application and inherited from System Creator. Similarly, Linux and MongoDB will be provided by application and inherited from application system. System Creator will have factory method. Linux Creator will create Linux system and MongoDB Creator will create MongoDB system. That's wonderful. But in future, more systems have to be added like Windows and MySQL. So lot more subclasses will be introduced with parallel class of hierarchy. It will make the design complex. We want to avoid this complexity. Okay. We will delegate the object creation responsibility using composition instead of subclassing. So we will have application system class and different type of systems like Linux, MongoDB, etc. will be inherited from application system. System Creator will have instance of application system, so it will be able to create different systems like Linux, MongoDB. Okay, let's stick to Linux and MongoDB only. But what if the object requires different states? For example, Linux object has some changes in processor, memory, image, etc. Can we think of having classes for different states? No way. It will require unnecessary classes for different states. Okay, so can we think of passing different parameters to constructor for different states? Of course not. It will become so complex and will require a lot of hard coding and will make the changes difficult in future. What if Linux object is composite object and requires a lot of processing for creating object? Creating it is very expensive and creating it multiple times is not a good option. Okay, we will copy the object so we can avoid complexity. But where is the object? Okay, we will have prototype object of all the classes at some place. And that will be used to clone the object to be created. But how this cloning will be done? Okay, we will have clone method in each class and that method will clone the object to be created. Good, that means we are able to create object without any complexity. But what about multiple classes or passing different parameters required for different states? No, we don't require multiple classes or passing different parameters. We will clone the object to be created for the most appropriate state and then we will initialize the object for changes with initialize method of class. Great. So we are done with the problem of different states and composite object creation. But suppose composite object has some references, then after copying, multiple object references will point to same memory. Okay. In case if composite object has references, then we will do deep copy. Otherwise, we can have shallow copy of object. Sometimes classes are known at runtime for instantiation of object. How that will be achieved? Yes, that can be achieved here. System Creator can receive the prototype object and can invoke the clone method of application system which is provided as interface for subclasses and inherited classes are creating copy of self. I have created UML diagram for this. The class System Creator has instance of application system. It requests the application system to clone the object. Application system is providing the interface clone for cloning the object. Linux and MongoDB are inherited from application system and implements the clone method. The clone method returns the copy of self. So we can see objects to be created are specified as prototypical instance and new objects are created by copying these prototypes. Congratulations! You have gone through a thought process and have come up with a design solution for a problem. Okay, let's see the structure of prototype design pattern. It will give you good understanding of participant classes, relationship between classes, and how all of them work together. Okay, let's see the participant classes. We have abstract class prototype. It has abstract method clone to provide interface for cloning the object. The concrete classes concrete prototype 1 and concrete prototype 2 implements the clone method to copy the object of self. The client has prototype instance and uses its clone interface to clone the prototype object. Okay, let's see how they will work together. The client has a prototype instance and uses its interface for cloning. Concrete prototype classes clone their respective object and return it to the client. So we can see we are creating new objects by copying prototype object. Okay, let's see some modifications and variations applied here. We are hiding the concrete classes information from client, so it will be easy to add new classes without much modification. We can have prototype manager to manage all the prototype objects so it can be accessed easily. We can add or remove objects at runtime by adding removing prototype object which is accessible to client. We can have prototype object with different values which will reduce the need of multiple classes for small changes in values. We can also have prototype object with most appropriate values and changed values can be initialized after cloning the object. Sometimes an object can also require prototype object, so we can have prototype object as part of another object too. Parallel subclass of hierarchy will be changed with composition delegation, so number of classes and complexity will be reduced. We can create object at runtime as object is created using clone method. So subclass object can be passed using base class and then each subclass can copy the object in their clone method. There is a cost to implement clone method in each subclass of prototype. Also, it will be difficult to add clone method in some already existing classes. There may be problem in cloning the object as some object may not support copy and some may have circular references. So where it can be applicable? Obviously in a scenario where we want to avoid parallel subclass hierarchies. In the situation where it is good to have a prototype and clone it, instead of creating a new object every time like composite object which requires a lot of processing and is expensive to do again and again. There can be different states of object and would like to avoid multiple classes for small changes or passing different parameters of state in constructor for creating objects. When classes are known at runtime for instantiation of object, for example by dynamic loading, some part of object is required to be cloned as it has to be created again and again, and that may be expensive or may have different states.